Many people believe that testosterone and other hormones drive muscle growth. So both the amount of testosterone you have at rest after you wake up and the amount of testosterone that you get after exercise, the acute rise, that determines how much muscle you can put on. What we did is we took 50 young university-age guys and we had them come in and train with us 4 times a week for 12 weeks. And we found that neither the amount of testosterone and other hormones that they had at rest or the amount of testosterone and other hormones that they had after exercise, that actually drove muscle growth. What was neat about our study is that we also took muscle biopsies, so we took pieces of their muscle, and we looked at hormones and receptors in there as well. What we found is that the amount of hormones that you have inside your muscle don't really predict how much muscle mass you have or how much muscle you can put on either, but the amount of hormone receptors, androgen receptors, those do. We're most interested in trying to figure out why we lose muscle mass as we age, why some people can put on more muscle than others, and why some people lose more muscle than others. So we think that androgen receptors are a piece of that puzzle. There's definitely a genetic blueprint that determines how much muscle someone has and how much muscle they can put on. The amount of androgen receptors you have is largely predetermined post-puberty. So there's no real exercise program that you can do that can change the amount of receptors you have. After aerobic exercise, you also get an increase in a lot of these hormones. And as you know, that does not necessarily mean they are gonna get bigger muscles from doing aerobic exercise. So that's a great rebuttal to the hormone hypothesis that these hormones are driving muscle growth.